wisdom of our God, revealed in all the universe. All things created by His hand and held together at His command. He knows the mysteries of the seas, the secrets of the stars are His. He guides the planets on their way and turns the earth through another day.
Welcome back, everyone. I hope your day is going well. We've got chapter 8, the commendation of wisdom. Does not wisdom call and understanding lift up her voice? On top of the heights, beside the way, where the paths meet, she takes her stand. Besides the gates, at the opening to the city, at the entrance of the doors, she cries out, "To you, O men, I call, and my voice is to the sons of men. O naive ones, understand prudence," another word for wisdom or good judgment. "And O fools, understand wisdom. Listen, for I will speak noble things, and the opening of my lips will reveal right things. For my mouth will utter truth, and wickedness is an abomination to my lips. All the utterances of my mouth are in righteousness. There is nothing crooked or perverted in them. They are all straightforward to him who understands, and right to those who find knowledge. Take my instruction and not silver, and knowledge rather than choicest gold. For wisdom is better than jewels, and all desirable things cannot compare with her." Words of wisdom, literally. All right, so the rest of this chapter, wisdom is going to be the one talking as if it were a person. So just keep that in mind. Everything that we're going to read will be from her voice. All right, verse 12. "I, wisdom, dwell with prudence, and I find knowledge and discretion. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil. Pride and arrogance in the evil way and the perverted mouth I hate. Counsel is mine and sound wisdom. I am understanding. Power is mine. By me," again wisdom, "kings reign and rulers decree justice. By me princes rule and nobles, all who judge rightly. I love those who love me, and those who diligently seek me will find me. Riches and honor are with me, enduring wealth and righteousness. My fruit is better than gold, even pure gold, and my yield better than choicest silver. I walk in the way of righteousness, in the midst of the paths of justice, to endow those who love me with wealth, that I may fill their treasuries. The Lord possessed me at the beginning of his way, before his works of old." So this is wisdom personified to claim credit for everything that God created, so that wisdom was first, as God was eternally first. Christ used his eternal wisdom in creation. Verse 23, "From everlasting I was established, from the beginning, from the earliest times of the earth. When there were no depths, I was brought forth, when there were no springs abounding with water. Before the mountains were settled, before the hills, I was brought forth. While he had not yet made the earth and the fields, nor the first dust of the world. When he established the heavens, I was there. When he inscribed a circle on the face of the deep. When he made firm the skies above. When the springs of the deep became fixed. When he set for the sea its boundary so that the water would not transgress his command, when he marked out the foundations of the earth. Then I was beside him as a master workman, and I was daily his delight, rejoicing always before him, rejoicing in the world, his earth, and having my delight in the sons of men. Now therefore, O sons, listen to me, for blessed are they who keep my ways. Heed instruction and be wise, and do not neglect it. Blessed is the man who listens to me, watching daily at my gates, waiting at my doorposts. For he who finds me finds life and obtains favor from the Lord. But he who sins against me injures himself. All those who hate me love death. So there is a time in life when it's good to be a wise guy. All right, well, y'all know that I love you. Let's go ahead and close it out in prayer. Dear Lord, we want to continue asking you to provide us with wisdom, discernment, and good judgment. Help us, Lord, to diligently seek you and to continue learning how to live and walk like you. Fill our hearts with a passion to hate evil, pride, arrogance, perverted mouths, and crooked speech. May everything we do and say be with honest and pure motives, with no intent of inflicting harm upon anyone. If we're upset with somebody, give us the strength and self-control to hold back our tongues and lean on you. In those moments, if we feel the need to speak, may we speak to you alone and know that you're aware and are involved. And rather than stay angry with somebody, may we pray for their salvation and correction of their wrong ways. Lord, we do rejoice in the assurance of knowing that our sins are forgiven. Amen. We are very aware of our eternal freedom because of you, and we know that we are now free indeed, free from enslavement to the law and liberated from the bondage of sin. Enable us, Lord, to stand firm in that freedom. Please safeguard our hearts and seal our deliverance, so that we shall never be subject to any yoke other than the easy yoke and light burden of you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus, thank you for hearing our cries to you. We do desperately want to reflect and emulate you in all that we do. Please continue delivering us from temptation and evil, especially as the days grow more dark and evil before the dawn of your return. In your name, Lord, we trust and rest. Amen. Good stuff, guys. As I said, I love you. Thanks for being here. God bless your day. Lord willing, I'll see you tomorrow. Take care.